A very good morning to you children. Welcome to Bhartesh Central School, Halga, Grade 2, Subject Computer, and I'm your teacher, Aisha S. Khan. In today's class, we are going to learn Unit 2, that is Parts of a Computer. We all have used the computer, children. A computer consists of different parts. Yes? Now, let us understand what are the different parts of the computer and how do they work. The first one is the keyboard. The keyboard is used to type numbers, letters and symbols. It also has some special function, keys too. We use the keyboard to type and to give instruction to the computer, and it has number of keys on it. Children, there are different keys, right? The number keys, the alphabet keys, the function keys, the arrow keys, etc. Now, what is monitor? As you see in the picture, it is looking just like a TV screen, right? So, a monitor is nothing but the screen of the computer. It is like a TV screen. The computer gives us information through the monitor. We can watch different cartoons, then movies and various other things on the monitor. The computer gives us information through the monitor. Now let's see what is central processing unit. The central processing unit, also known as CPU, is the brain of the computer, children. It is placed on the motherboard, and the motherboard is inside the CPU cabinet. Can you see in the picture, children? You can see a CPU, then you can see a motherboard, and you can see a CPU cabinet. So a CPU is placed on the motherboard, and this motherboard is placed inside the CPU cabinet. So when we type using a keyboard or click the mouse, information is sent to the CPU. The CPU processes this information. It then gives the result on the monitor. What is mouse? A mouse is a pointing device. The arrow you see on the monitor is the mouse pointer. It moves as you move the mouse. A mouse is used for pointing the things on the computer, children. When we hold a mouse, you see an arrow on the monitor, right? So that is called as a mouse pointer. Whenever you move your hand, like when you move the mouse pointer also moves. We use mouse to give instructions to the computer. We do this by clicking the mouse buttons. Okay, we can open windows, we can draw, and we can do several other tasks using the mouse. Now, the next part of the computer is the speaker. We can listen to a music or information in a louder voice using speakers. For example, see, when any function is going on in your home, right, that time big speakers are attached to the music system so that you can hear the music or whatever is said in a louder voice. For example, when Ganesh Chaturthi will be there, in the different mandaps, speakers are mounted. Why? So that you can see, you can listen to the prayers in a louder voice. Okay. The next is the microphone, children. We use microphone to record our voice on the computer. We also use the microphone to talk during a video chat. Suppose you are chatting with somebody. Okay, you are doing a video chat. At that time, you require this microphone. And by using a microphone, you can record your own voice also. If you are a good singer, you can record your voice and save it on your computer. The next part of computer is the printer. A printer creates a paper copy of what is there on the monitor. Means, suppose I have typed a letter on the monitor and I want a copy of it. I want a hard copy of it. That is a soft copy. On the monitor, I want a hard copy, means I want the print on my paper. So I use a printer. We can use keyboard or mouse to send command to the printer. The CPU processes the command and sends the information to the printer. The printer then prints on a paper what we see on the monitor. For example, children, when your exams will be going on, that time you get the question paper, right? How do you get that question paper? First, the teachers type the question paper on the computer in the word pad. And after that, they save it and then they take a print of it by using a printer. And this way you get a question paper. I hope the different parts of the computer are clear to you, children. If you have any doubt, please contact me. Thank you, children. Have a fabulous day.